to take a lot of heat for this film. Do you know you guys are going to take some real interesting interview questions?
We live in an oven. Yeah. That's how much heat we're going to take.
Yeah, yeah.
But that's always the way it is.
And she said, David Lynch, he's such a strange bird. I've heard that he doesn't have a refrigerator in his house. In fact, I don't even think he has a kitchen. Now, that's odd, if it's true, is it?
I have a refrigerator.
Okay, I want to be sure of it.
I've seen it. I can vouch for that.
And you have food in your house and you have a kitchen?
I have, yes, I do. I don't cook in the house.
Mm-hmm.
And that's because of the odor and the film develops on the walls.
Should I pursue this, Kyle? I don't know, Kyle. There's something that should...
It makes complete sense to me. Yes, absolutely.
The relationship that you two seem to have is so terrific. You know those kind of relationships where you don't have to finish sentences?
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Of course.
And they get it?
Mm-hmm.
Do you now have that?
Yes, we...
I think we had that from the
Yes,
day.
We...
You do?
See, he's rusty. I haven't seen him for a while.
It's been a while.
And you've worked with David Lynch a lot, haven't
right.
you?
Right, yeah, we did Dune together. That was the first thing. And Blue Velvet and now Twin Peaks.
Yeah. Of the three projects that you've worked together on, which do you feel the best about as far as your work in it goes?
Twin Peaks.
Really?
Yeah, I think so. I'm most comfortable.
Yeah. What kind of guy is he?
Dale Cooper?
No, David Lynch.
David Lynch.
Yeah.
I said it. Well, it's hard. He's kind of hard to put, to tell us. I'll tell you a story about him.
Okay.
He came to my house one day to shoot a picture of my steps. But he wasn't just going to shoot a picture of the steps. He set up two little girders, a piece of wire, a little plastic baby, two men with chewing gum on their head, took a camera back here and took a snapshot of it.
Wow.
That's about the best way I can describe David Lynch.
And when you asked him what he was doing, what did he say? You know.
Well, he said he was setting up a still life and you know, with my steps. He just liked the way the steps looked with this...
And that was it. That was the sole purpose. He was coming
that was
up.
It. Yeah. He came over to do that.
Are you friendly with the man?
Yeah. We go to dinner.
Yeah. Now, what was Dune? Dune was not a big success, was it? Of the films that he has done, it was probably the least successful.
Yeah, I think so.
Does that trouble you that it wasn't that big a deal?
No, not really. I think he redeemed himself, and I think I did too with Blue Velvet.
Right.
And so, you know, feel pretty good about that.
Good work. And from the crew as well. Got it.
Yeah.
I'll tell you what you're going to see. I'm pointing to one, and then you're looking at me like, is that it? And then I'm going to go, and you're going to see me lean.
That's great.
That's David's idea.
Yeah, that's pretty cool.
That's why it's a great idea. My idea is, David's idea is great.
His ideas are great. Turn around. Oh. Walking on the wild side of the whatever.
We're gonna put your monitor in here.
Oh, where's Gail?
Yeah, we can mark it.
I thought he was in there.
Where did he go? Wait.
There he is.
Oh, you're a funny one. Okay. You can slap me.
No.
Yeah, you can. No, come on. Slap me. You're pissed off. Slap me.
I don't want to.
Oh, sweetheart.
Here, let me do it.
Okay.
Oh, volunteers, line up.
Go ahead.
Wait, no, okay.
I've been hit before.
How? Okay, like this.
Yeah,
like that.
Yeah.
Like that hard.
Yeah, yeah, but quick.
But
you know?
But I'll go with it.
Yeah, okay.
So when
Let's
you
try
make,
it on you.
So,
I don't
yeah.
Want...
So,
oh,
so I'll go
that
with
hurt?
It. No,
that
that's
was,
perfect.
You didn't go enough.
I went a little bit.
But there was a that I felt like I really contacted you.
But
should
it was
we try
good.
It again?
Yeah.
I don't want to.
You don't want to bruise him. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, but it's like if you follow through, you know.
Oh yeah, like, but then you've got to shoot it from. Isn't
yeah.
there?
We're going to be in closer.
Yeah.
Anyway, so.
Okay.
You,
Naomi, it's a good
I'm
idea.
Bad at this stuff. I wasn't.
Yeah, but yeah. follow through,
yeah.
like that. Okay. Just dust them. Yeah, that's
yeah.
pretty good.
Yeah, that
that's
works.
Pretty good. If we put a sound to that, it might work.
Okay.
If he does hit you and you get a big bruise.
Just too right. bad.
I've got a few days off.
Nice. Then there's no sleep at all for doing Naomi. We just keep her up 24/7.
24/7. Keep shooting.
Okay, let's shoot this puppy.
Ready for rehearsal.
Kale.
Kale.
Your full name is Kyle MacLachlan.
but I call you Kale. And I remember why I call you Kale. Dino De Laurentiis could never pronounce Kyle's name. He called him Kale. And so I started calling Kyle Kale, and that's the way it's been for years and years and years.
Kale, don't talk so much during the scene.
It's going to be very hard.
Okay, yeah, you got to stick to the script. Don't ad lib like that.
I wasn't trained that way as an actor. Really. David pretty much trained me as an actor.
Dougie!
Honey!
Cut it! Beautiful, Kale. Beautiful. Good deal, you guys. And ideas started coming. And we would write at Mark's house. And he had a chair that reminded me of a kind of a chair the psychiatrist would put a patient in. Uh-huh. A kind of a chaise lounge.
Right.
Black leather. And it was a little slippery, and that's where I would lay down in there. And
stare at the ceiling.
And then we were writing, and we wrote like that. And he drank soy milk. And I think he got me whole milk for coffees.
Right.
And that was really nice.
Whole milk is sort of key.
Yeah. And but he had
no,
a lot
soy
of...
soy is better.
You like soy.
Well.
Yeah. Well, anyway,
we can differ.
That's what makes the world go round.
Exactly.
Matchkin likes soy milk.
Right. Yes.
So if she visited Mark, you'd be set. Yeah.
Yep.
Me, I like whole milk, and when I visited Mark, I was fresh out of luck.
Clear the floor and make way for this one here.
Ladies and gentlemen. It was bound to happen. Our dear black-suited Dougie is a wrap. Now, ladies and gentlemen.
Special Agent
Dale
Cooper.
I remember thinking, I thought, I seem a little young for the character, I thought. But then I thought, well, that doesn't really matter, really. He can be any age, you know. But in my head, I sort of was thinking, oh, maybe he should be older.
No, but Cooper has, such high intelligence and intuition.
Right.
It doesn't matter how old you are.
Right.
You know, it doesn't matter one little bit.
Right. It took me
You're the guy.
It took me a long time to figure that out. But
all right, I'm gonna get a coffee and a
get that, Kale, and enjoy every bit of it.
All right,
thanks. No, you gotta put 502.
Now, the position for the thumbs up is kind of critical. That's against your white shirt. That's better. To the right, right there.
The same angle towards him, just bring it in like that.
Okay. Was Boise? Born in Boise?
I was born in Missoula, Montana.
Missoula. I get that.
I lived in Boise.
That's right.
And I love Boise, Idaho.
Yeah.
I lived in Spokane.
Okay.
And I was born, I lived in Sandpoint, Idaho.
Yep.
And I was born in Missoula.
Yeah, that's right. Montana.
My dad died in Missoula.
Your dad died in Missoula?
He lived in Missoula and died there.
Wow.
This is crazy. Yeah.
Incredible, Matchkin.
Yeah.
Wow.
Thank you.
What sign of the zodiac are you?
Aries.
You're in Aries.
I have the same birthday as your daughter, Jennifer. We were born on the same day.
And Francis Ford Coppola.
And Francis Ford Coppola.
Yeah, so happy birthday to you all.
What's your sign, Kale?
Me? Oh, Pisces.
Yeah.
Yes. Kale's a drinker and a dreamer.
You got that right.
And what are you?
I'm a Camp Aquarius. I'm on the border.
Oh. On the border. Nice.
Go?
No. The other way.
Turn.
So lower that down a little bit. So when we move in on you, you're finding them in the woods. And we'll leave enough room for it to dissolve. And then I'll say drop out, and you'll do one of your famous drops.
there's a scene early on where you're talking to your supervisor, Gordon Cole, from the Truman's, I think it's in the conference room. Mm-hmm. I can't remember exactly. Mm-hmm. And I think I just did the voice, to be on the other side of it.
Right.
And I found myself talking, loud through there for some reason.
Right.
And so the thing got born.
That's funny. Well, I remember you would, this was either before monitors or you just never used it. You were always right next to the camera or right below the camera watching the scene so that you were as close as you could be to getting what the
That's
camera was.
That's where I figured you're supposed to be, see the scene.
See the scene. It's not so common.
You know,
you used to sort of talk and we would basically try to crack each other up.
Uh-huh.
You were trying to always make me laugh. Or there's a couple of times that we got into trouble.
So much fun.
It was fun.
Yeah.
Moving on here.
I can do it. We don't need the green screen or FX. That's good.
Now make your whole front of your face a foot longer. Go out toward this thing.
Okay, let's do this, George. Step to the right a little bit, and let's make the eye line this box here.
I need to rehearse with him.
Action, Kale. And this thing is laughing at you, screaming. You look around, start the panic. Drop. Incredible.
No wonder.
Because it's a little bit of a cut. That was real good.
Okay. No, right. It's already 7.
David is all about what happens in the moment of creation in front of the camera. So for me, the thing that I enjoyed the most about working with David, and the thing that I try, there's some of my fans. Hello. Not really. They're shouting for Jennifer Love Hewitt. But with David, it's all about like that. It's what happens in the moment. And he will incorporate anything, any unusual, crazy. If a bird flew through and sat down here on my shoulder for no reason, we'd just keep rolling and we would incorporate that in the scene. And that's something that I love about David.